Okay, hello and good day everyone, no? So today we will discuss yeah, ito pa think na kagad. Okay. Okay. So today we will discuss about the common terms in statistics. Okay? So dito sa common terms of statistics kasama dito yung population. No, population it refers to the complete set of individuals, objects, places, or events under the study, such as the residents in Quezon City, the students in this school, or the viewers of a particular TV shows. No, so yun ang tinutukoy ng population. Grupo siya ng complete set of individual na kakailanganin doon sa study. Sample naman, no, is the small portion or part of a population. So parte lang siya ng population yung sample. No, kung saan diyan kumukuha yung researcher ng i-present at saka i-interpret. It is the subgroup, subset, or the representative of a population. Okay? Kasi it is very difficult naman as a researcher to organize, to represent, to present a data, no, using the whole population. Syempre para medyo ano naman, medyo reduce naman sa time, no, you will get a sample of it. Okay? Next, parameter naman, the numerical value that describes the characteristics of a population. Okay? So, yan. That is the parameter, no? The numerical value na kung saan dinidescribe yung isang characteristic ng population. Kung ilang thousands ba, ilang million na population. Example, proportion of the Filipino population who believe that the current president is doing a good job. Okay? So that is an example of parameter or a portion, a proportion, or a percent, no, parameter yon. Now this one is the example of population, no. Again, population ito naman yung sample. So example galing na sa population. Okay, now data naman, no, are facts or set of information or observations under study. Okay, so it can be gathered from a population or from a sample. Okay, so yan ang data, yung mga facts or insight of information or observation, no, na pwede mong makuha doon sa population or kaya sa sample. Dalawang klase yung data natin. Una yung qualitative data or data which can assume values that manifest the concept of attributes, no. So these are categories which differ according to the characteristics they possess, no. Kaya nga tinawag na qualitative data, it talks about the quality of the data. This data cannot be meaningfully added, subtracted, multiplied, or divided. Okay? So yung mga data na hindi natin magagamitan ng add, no, or ma-undergo ng mga operations tulad ng add, subtraction, multiplication, or division. Example here, yung date of birth, no? Yung date hindi mo pwedeng i-add yan, i-subtract kasi date 'yon, no? Qualitative 'yon. Code number hindi rin pwedeng ma-add or ma-subtract o ma-multiply or ma-divide kasi nga code 'yon, code number, hindi pwedeng mag-allow. Zip code, telephone numbers. Okay? Then quantitative data naman are data which are numerical in nature, no? Unlike in qualitative. So doon kasi sa qualitative, yung number mismo kinagamit to describe, no, the attributes of the given data. While in this one, hindi. No, numerical in nature, meaning to say, pwede siyang ma-add, ma-subtract, or ma-divide, no? So they can indicate how much of a given characteristics an individual, object, or event possesses. This can be subjected to arithmetic operations, just like addition, subtraction, and division. Now, example here, your age, no? Weekly allowance, height, size of family, no, number of population, no, example of quantitative data yan. Here, no, example, no, the difference of quantitative and qualitative data. So dito, no, quantitative data that is numerical, no, height of first graders, no, okay, weight of sumo wrestlers, duration of red lights, no, pwede mag-change yan, age of Olympians, distance of planets, money in 401,000 plants, temperature of coffee. Then for qualitative data, no, or categorical, we have happiness rating, gender, pass or fail, eye color, interview transcript, categories of plants, descriptive temperature of coffee. So ito, dito pinaka the best na part, no, ng pag-differentiate ng quantitative at qualitative data. So if you're going to to look, no, for the temperature of coffee, no, in a numerical form in or in a quantitative data, ang magiging data natin yan is 200 Fahrenheit. So automatically binibigay natin yung number of degrees. But in qualitative data, sasabihin lang natin yan very hot or very cold. Okay? Ganun lang. Pag-describe lang, very hot or very cold. Now, next naman sa data is yung variable, no? It's a quantity which may take on different values. It is a characteristic of a population or sample which makes the members different from each other, no? So yan, variable. Mga variable natin, tulad ng mga students age of 10, no? Students age of 12, no? Ganun. Meron tayong variables dyan. Then, discrete variable naman. We have types of variable. Una yung discrete, no? Is a variable whose values are obtained through the process of counting. No, these are variables that can assume finite number of values. Example, the number of chairs in a classroom. No, yan, variable yon, number of chairs. Kasi nga, meron tayong ano, na-involve dito yung process of counting. Okay? And then continuous variable naman is a variable that does not fall under the category of discrete. No? So opposite siya ng discrete. These are variables that can be obtained through the process of measuring. Kung sa discrete counting, dito naman process of measuring. It can assume any value within a specified interval or range. Example yan, height, weight, time, and temperature. That is our all example of continuous variable. Then, next one is constant. No? It's a quantity which does not vary or is fixed. No? So, makukuha lang yan sa variable. No? Especially in a discrete, pag nagbigay ng number of chairs, na yung number of chairs na bibigay, let's say for example 25, yun ang constant na natin. Okay? It is property or characteristic of a population or a sample which makes the members of the group similar to each other. Okay? Kasi nga constant, it doesn't change. Now, let us have an exercise. Identify the population in the following research or study. Number one, the effect of the use of contraceptives in Filipino women age 40 and above. No? So, what could be our population here in this study? It is the Filipino women age 40 and above. No? So, yun ang magiging population natin. Next, a survey conducted among third year student of Bridgetown University regarding their career preference. So, what could be our population here? That is the third year student of Bridgetown University. Okay? Number three, the development of special children in Barangay Polo under special education program. So what is our population here? No? Special children in Barangay Polo. Okay? Yan ang magiging population natin. Next, determine whether the given data is qualitative or quantitative. Number one, among 5,000 housewives surveyed, 4,500 recognized the GM detergent bar. Okay? What could be yung data natin dito is given na, no? So we have 5,000 housewives surveyed, 4,500 recognized the GM detergent bar, no? So that is our data here. So what type of data is that? Is it qualitative or quantitative? That is qualitative. Why? Kasi, no? It only describes, no, the number of housewives that recognized the GM detergent bar. Next, number two, a university named the top 5 courses taking for the last 3 years. So dito sa data natin, ano yon? Ano yung anong type of data na meron tayo dito? Qualitative or quantitative? That is quantitative. Okay, quantitative number. A university named top 5 courses taking for the last 3 years. Next, a domestic airline altimeter reports a height of 27,439 feet. Okay? So the data, yung data natin is an example of quantitative data because of the height. Okay? Ito quantitative kasi nga may years. So. Ito naman, height. Kaya quantitative. Next. Okay, so that's all. No? So that's all. Okay, thank you for listening. And again, don't forget to answer exercises. Okay? So goodbye and God bless.